Donc, Anne-Laure, tu es chercheur au sein de l'équipe Straub, qui est basée au synchrotron à Grenoble. Et du coup, je vais te laisser la parole pour présenter ton activité de recherche au sein de cette équipe, donc basée à Grenoble.
Ouais. Alors, est-ce que vous voyez mes slides? Alors, je vais passer en mode écran. Voilà,
Voilà, c'est
c'est
bon,
bon?
ça passe.
Okay, great. So I'll keep going in English too. So I'm Anne-Laure Bullin. I'm working in the synchrotron radiation for biomedicine group in Grenoble, and I'm working on application of on radiotherapeutic application of nanoscintillators. So first of all, I'm going to introduce what are nanoscintillators. So those are nanoparticles that have the ability to emit light when they are subjected to ionizing radiation, such as X-rays, for instance. So we could try to use them to potentiate the efficacy of radiotherapy. And to do that, we actually are counting on three different effects that we are hoping in inducing during radiotherapy. The first one is what we call a radiation dose enhancement effect. So this effect is mostly due to the composition itself of the nanoscintillator. So those are nanoparticles that are usually made of high Z element atoms. And if you accumulate in the tumor prior to radiotherapy high Z elements, what you're going to have is an enhancement of the dose deposited around the nanoparticle during the irradiation. So this is the first effect that we are investigating. The second one is, so if you have a nanoscintillator, basically by choosing its composition, you can have a spectra that would be emitted between the UV or the infrared. And if you have a nanoscintillator that emits in the UV, and most importantly in the UVC, you can have some direct damage to the DNA. So that's potentially a second effect that we can induce with those type of nanoparticles. And finally, the last one is a little bit more tricky. If you conjugate on the surface of the nanoscintillator some molecules that we call photosensitizer and that are a non-toxic molecule when they are in the dark, you can induce what we call the photodynamic therapy effect. So this effect is actually due to the light activation of those photosensitizer that will create reactive oxygen species that will induce an anti-tumor efficacy. So the idea is that you excite the nanoscintillator with the X-ray. The light that the nanoscintillator emit will excite the photosensitizer directly in the tumor, and you can like that. Is currently used in the clinic to treat certain type of tumor. So the idea is that you inject the photosensitizer, and after a certain delay, the photosensitizer is accumulated in the tumor, and you come shine the light with a laser. So that's a particularly efficient effect. The issue is that you need to bring the light in the body. So because of the poor penetration of light in tissue, you will be limited to superficial tumors or small tumors. So the idea here is to replace the light by those nanoscintillator excited by X-rays. And so like that, you can actually reach deeper tumor and potentially more massive tumors. So you keep like that the positive part of the PDT that you have no toxicity without photoactivation, and you still have a local effect. And you overcome this limitation of PDT that you are limited by the shallow penetration of light in tissue. And so in that case, the nanoscintillator would actually be a local source of light that can induce PDT in deep tissues. So to come to the project that I'm leading today, it's actually it was built from my past experience. So I'm a physicist by training. I'm not really a biologist at all. And during my PhD that I did in Lyon, I worked on the process of energy relaxation in nanoscintillators. So by using different approach, the first one was to use the spectroscopic characterization of the nanoparticles to actually validate the presence of an energy transfer leading to the PDT activation, but really from the physics point of view. And I also developed some Monte Carlo simulation that allows us to estimate the potential efficacy that we can get with those mechanisms. So either the X-ray PDT or the radiation dose enhancement effect. And then I moved to a bit more biology perspective in a lab where people were actually focusing on PDT. And there I developed some 3D culture models as well as the assay to actually validate those models. So I worked on viability assay, for instance. And then I used those models and those assay to investigate the combination of PDT, low-dose PDT with radiotherapy to try to see if those two therapy could actually have a synergistic effect. And with all those little bricks, I came back to Grenoble in 2017, and I started investigating the efficacy of nanoscintillator to actually enhance the dose deposition in tumor during radiotherapy, most in that case upon synchrotron radiotherapy. And we demonstrated that we have quite a strong efficacy of this nanoscintillator to do a radiation dose enhancement in vitro as well as in vivo. And with all those elements together, the project that I'm leading today is based on those nanoscintillators, and we are trying to investigate their radiotherapeutic application in different aspects, starting from in silico simulation to optical characterization, analysis on DNA, as well as in vitro and in vivo study. So of course, that's a quite collaborative project. So our group, I'm closely working with Hélène Elhomme, also from the Strobe group. And we have several students working with us. So Antonia, who's focusing mostly on the DNA aspect, Thibaut and Anthony, who are two engineers. One is a biologist, the other one a physicist. And we have been joined by two master students recently, Anna Maria and Sarah, again, a physicist and a biologist. One is working mostly on the simulations, the other one on the biological effect. And we have many other collaborators. I just listed the main ones distributed within those different institutes in Grenoble, in Lyon mostly. And I would like to thank the financial support as well as you for your attention. Thank you.
Merci Anne-Laure. Merci Anne-Laure. J'aurais une petite question. Bon là, dans la flèche que tu présentes, on voit bien que vous allez, on va dire, de l'étude fondamentale jusqu'à l'application en préclinique. Est-ce que ça veut dire qu'à ce stade, vous avez déjà l'ambition de réaliser des essais cliniques en utilisant ces nanoscintillateurs, ou à quel stade vous en êtes aujourd'hui?
Alors, en fait, on fait un peu, enfin, je vais pas dire tout en parallèle, mais on a certaines certaines nanoparticules qu'on a déjà emmenées sur les aspects in vivo, d'autres sur lesquelles on démarre, donc on est plus sur les parties en amont. On est en discussion, en fait, avec des médecins. Donc, pour l'instant, les nanoparticules qu'on a vont pas forcément passer en clinique tout de suite, mais on essaye de garder une collaboration assez proche, pour essayer de faire en sorte que les nanoparticules, quand on en a, qu'ils soient vraiment efficaces, qu'on soit dans une démarche dans laquelle on puisse les emmener en clinique, donc essayer de faire attention à tout ce qui est problème de toxicité, principalement, c'est la principale difficulté. Et voilà, donc on est en discussion assez étroite, ouais, avec notamment Camille Véry, Jacques Balosso, qui étaient sur Grenoble, et qui suivent bien ces applications aussi de radiothérapie synchrotron pour essayer de combiner tout ça ensemble. Donc c'est le long terme goal, on va dire.
Oui, bien sûr. Ouais. Très bien. Merci pour cette présentation. Je crois qu'on aura un petit complément d'ici deux présentations avec celle de Mantes, ouais, qui fait partie des chercheurs avec qui tu collabores sur cette activité de recherche. Merci Anne-Laure.